guys, I'm back showing you guys the new 360 wig made by Love Me Virgin Hair. While I show you guys this wig, I'm just going to give you a little bit of information about this specific wig. You have full customizing power with this wig. You can choose up to 4 bundles to be installed on it. And as you can see, there are like individual tracks sewn on the wig. With 2 bundles, it is like having a 150% density lace wig, with 3, 180%, and with 4, 220%. It can be like a full lace wig with a natural hairline and full parting only in the front, however, and you can still do a ponytail. You can see I still bleached the knot, and it pretty much came already plucked, customized on the hairline, so I didn't really have to touch that. An elastic band is also added to the bottom of the wig for an easy install. And so for a more secure ponytail, I am going to add a comb, and I'm going to show you guys how I did it right now. Oh, and let me mention that purchasing this wig is 30% cheaper than purchasing a full lace wig. So here's my model, and as you can see, she has a lot of hair. She's trying to stay away from flat ironing so much, so we're just gonna give her hair a much needed break with the 360 wig. So I'm just gonna do a quick blowout because I didn't want to braid her hair curly, and she's tender head, so that would not have worked out. So for any of you who've had concerns or are scared to install wigs on someone with, you know, a lot of hair, here's a quick and easy braid pattern. The key is to basically pull the braid up into the cornrow, kind of at the top of the head, because there is so much hair. You don't want to wait until you get too low or else it will be bulky. But you also don't want to pull too hard. You want to make sure that there is no tension on the back of the head. Braids don't have to be perfect. As long as they're flat, that's all that matters. And she's probably going to end up taking these braids out anyway. So I'm going to just pin the last braid up and put a wig cap on. And as you can see, I kind of placed it on half of her head because of the color of the cap, and I didn't really want to add makeup to it, so I was just going to let her scalp actually come through the lace. And when I tell you guys, this is literally the easiest install with using this type of wig with the elastic band. There's no need for any other types of band or adhesive or anything, and I'm going to show you guys exactly how to do it. So you see the first elastic band, you're going to pull it over and then clip it to the other side, I guess, and then you're going to do the same with the other part, and then you're going to actually use the comb up under. after I get that secure, I'm going to go ahead and cut the lace. You don't want to chop any ears off, so have your client hold their ear while you cut around their ear. I tell you guys, this lace is literally very secure, and you want to make sure it's secure before you cut the lace in the front. So now I'm going to cut a little bit of baby hairs. Not too much, but you know, just a little something something. I get asked this all the time, what type of edge control. I use Carol's Daughter, and it can be found at Target. So continue to watch this video to watch me style it in a few different styles. So yeah, enjoy.
I don't know if it's fair, but I thought, how could I let you fall by yourself while I'm wasted with someone else? If we go down, then we go down together. They say you could do anything, they say that I was clever. If we go down, then we go down together. We'll get away with everything, and let's show them we are better. Thrill of it, getting drunk on the past, we were living it.